Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we will learn how to work around the forecast manager limitations where the totals in the forecast tab don't roll up to the manager's forecast. We'll prevent two solutions to help your managers see the forecast totals for their entire team. Let's go check out how to make the forecast tab really useful for our revenue leaders. All right, here we are in Salesforce and we are on the forecast tab and we can see that I am the head of sales. I've got two sales managers, Nate and Tara, that report to me. And then Nate and Tara also have two sales reps underneath them. Now, in a previous video, we'll give you the links below. We'll show you how we imported the quotas and we set up all the forecast types. In this video, we're going to show you how we're going to make it so that Nate can see values in these rollups right here. So he cannot see the totals by month. He cannot see the total for the 3 months up here. So he has no idea where his entire team is at versus their quota. He can go to each individual sales rep's forecast view and see those numbers. But when he wants to see his entire forecast, he can't. So we're going to show you two different options to work around this limitation. Now, option number one is we're going to import quotas for the managers on the existing forecast type. Now, there is only one forecast type to manage if we do it this way. So that's one of the pros. One of the cons is that you have to remember to filter out the managers from all of the reporting. And if your managers have opportunities that need to contribute to the forecast and you need to filter out your manager from that report, their opportunities are not going to count towards the team's quota. So if your managers have opportunities that need to be rolled up into their team, option number one is not going to work and you need to skip to option number two in this video where we'll show you how to set up a second forecast type. Now, option number two, we're going to set up a second forecast type. One of the pros is that you're going to use one forecast type for reporting and the managers will use a different forecast type to see their rollups within the forecast tab. Now, the cons to this one are you're going to have two different forecast types to manage. You'll need to load quotas into two different forecast types. And then you also have to remember to filter for the forecast type without the manager's quotas for all your reports, or else your information in your report is going to be inflated. Really, the difference between the two is whether or not your manager's opportunities need to roll up. All right, let's go into option one. Now, our first step is to load quotas in for the managers. Let's go check something out. Just want to show you our forecast settings right here. So we have one active forecast type, the revenue estimate by month, and this is the one that we're going to add quotas for. So we're going to go to data loader. And we're going to run a couple of exports. We're first going to export our forecasting quotas. Okay, we have 48 extractions. So these are the quotas for all of our sales reps that we imported. So we have four sales reps and we have our monthly quotas. So 4 times 12 is 48, which is correct. We're going to run a second export. This is on the user object. We're just going to pull down the ID and the name. Let's pull up both of our files here. Let's go ahead and start preparing this file. So we're going to delete some of the columns. We don't have a forecasting group. If you have that, you want to leave that in. We do not need any of these. We don't need product family. If you have your forecast in by product family, you'll need to leave that in as well. I'm just making this a little bit easier to work with. All right, so now what I want to do is get the names of the sales reps who own these quotas over onto the spreadsheet. So I'm just going to do a VLOOKUP here on the owner ID. And there's my names. And now I need to get the manager name in here. And then if you have a mapping, if you have a lot of sales reps and a lot of managers, you're not going to want to do this by hand like I am, but I only have four, so it's nice and easy. Okay, now we're just going to insert a pivot table because I need to get the totals by manager. And then I'm going to say manager name and then quota amount. And our start date is going to be in the columns. So these are the totals for each of our managers by month. So now I'm going to prepare a new spreadsheet. And I'm going to need these columns, some of these columns, not all of them, some of them. So let's just copy these. I won't need the ID. I'll need the forecasting type. I'll need the quota amount. I'll need the owner ID. I'll need the date and the name. So I'm not going to need the owner name. So I'm going to come back over to my sheet here and I'm going to copy Nate's. And then I can transpose this. And then once you do this, once you have a template, so you don't have to start from scratch all the time. So there's Nate's totals. And we'll get Tara's. Now I need the owner ID over here, so I'll just do a VLOOKUP to get that. And then we also have me, the head of sales. Need to put in quotas for me too. And that's just gonna be Tara plus Nate. So it'll be these totals down here. All right, so our spreadsheet is all set. Let's save our file. Okay, now we're going to insert these records. I'm going to insert this into the forecasting quota object. We have 36 rows, which is correct because we're inserting quotas for 3 people. And that's correct. All this is mapped correctly. That's all we need to import these. Okay, all 36 were successful. Let's close some of this out. Now let's go check out our forecast tab for our managers and see if this is all loaded correctly. We'll refresh. And all right, we can see totals. So we can see the total for Nate's team. Let's go ahead and look at mine. Let's see if I can see totals. Oh yeah. So I can see totals here, all rolling up all nicely. This is great. So now let's look at our reporting. We created these reports in a different video. We'll show you the link down below in the description. So on our actual versus quota report, we'll come check that out and we're gonna see that it's all wonky. So let's look at our forecast tab. So our total quota for July should be 950,000. If we come over here to our report, we can see that the total quota here is 2.85 million. It's because Nate and Lila and my quotas are all included in this report. So we would have to filter out any manager's quotas from this report. We're gonna have to go and modify our custom report type, and we're going to add a field for the owner role to the report. So the report type that is driving this report is the forecasting quotas with forecasting quota items. We're gonna come here and edit the layout. This is one of the best kept secrets that you can get to all these related fields through this little add fields related via lookup. We're gonna go to the owner and then we can pull in the role name of the quota owner. And then that dropped the field right here. It's kind of hard to see. We're gonna create a new section and we're gonna drag that field down in that new section. Just keeps it nice and clean. We'll click save here. And now our roles are set up so that the names are very consistent. So let's go show you what that role hierarchy looks like. So the role names that we don't want to include are head of sales and our sales managers. So let's go ahead and come to our report. We're going to refresh. We need to edit this report. We're going to add a filter. We should be able to find the field owner role name. Perfect. And so it's going to be not equal to head of sales. And then we're going to add another one for owner role name. Does not contain sales manager team. All right, so we'll save and run this. And now we should see our quota is 950,000, which we do. Perfect. So our managers are now, and our head of sales are now filtered out of this report. All right, now let's check out option number two. Option number two requires us to create a second forecast type. We're gonna go to forecast settings. We're not gonna get into the details about what we're doing, how we're doing it. You need to watch our initial setup video if you wanna understand how to do that. We're just gonna set one up here really fast based on the opportunity amount. We're gonna call this revenue estimate by month, rollups, just so we can tell the difference. You can call yours whatever you like. We're gonna make this active. And now for option two, what we need to do is we're going to load in quotas for all of our sales reps and all of our managers. So the easiest way to do this is to export all of the quotas that we imported for your other forecast type and add in what's missing. So you'll basically go through the same exercise that we just went through, but you'll need to make sure that all your sales reps and your managers' quotas are imported into this forecast type. So we will need to run a query in our developer console right here because we need to get the forecast type ID of the new forecast that we just created. All right, so what we're looking for is revenue estimate by month rollups, and this is our forecast type ID that we'll need to load our quotas. Now I'm gonna cheat here. I'm just gonna export all the quotas out of our other forecast type here real fast, jam out to some tunes while I go through that exercise. Okay, so here's my file. I can delete the system mod stamp. I don't need that. So this has all of my sales reps and my managers in it. If yours does not have the managers, then you'll need to add the manager's forecasts in following the same process that I did in option one. Now we don't need this ID. So this is the old forecast type ID or old forecast quota ID. And then what we need to do is replace this forecast type ID with the one that we got in the developer console. Right here. We'll update that. Okay, I don't need this quota quantity. Our forecast is based on the amount field. Okay, so this is ready for import. I'll go ahead and click save. I'll pull up data loader here. I'll run an insert. Going to insert into the forecasting quota object. All right, those are all the fields that I need to map. Okay, so 84 records were inserted successfully. So now let's go check out our forecast tab. Let's go ahead and refresh this. And then we should see our new forecast type show up, which we do right here, revenue estimate by month rollups. So this is the forecast type that your managers would use. And the forecast type that you would use for reporting is the revenue estimate by month. So the revenue estimate by month, if you're using option two, you would not have your manager's quotas in here. It would just be your sales rep quotas. And then you can include your manager's opportunities in there and not have any issues in reporting. Now, if you have two different forecast types going on, now you need to apply the appropriate filters to the appropriate reports so that the right forecast type is showing up in your reports. When you're running your reports, you're not going to want to have both forecast types in your report because it's going to show inflated numbers. If we come over to our actual versus quota report again, we're going to see inflated numbers here. So we can see everything is doubled for our sales reps here. So let's go ahead and put a filter on here. Let's pull up our developer console again. And what we need to use is this developer name. So if we go to our filters, how you filter for a specific forecast type is you use forecasting type API name. We'll put the developer name value in here. And then now we can see that this report is going to show 950,000 again. So we're using the same report for option one and option two, but you understand what we're doing here. If you wanted to only include the other forecast type, you would use the API name of that one because you can see all of your forecast type API names up here. And that's it. That's all you need for the workaround for your managers to be able to see the roll-ups in the forecast tab. That's it. That's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next videos we are working on that will show you how to use manager judgment and forecast adjustments. If you have pipeline review meetings where you track which deals are in or out of the forecast, these features can make this process a breeze. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you would like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.